Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to the Survivor Series with Doc Stout. I am playing Don't Starve. We are about to go back in and play with Wolfgang, starting day 5. If you recall from the last 2 episodes of the series, Wolfgang has plenty of food. He has become very mighty. However, we have yet to find a source of beefalo. We do, however, have a really nice hat. We have yet to find anything resembling a gold bar. Or a gold nugget, rather. So we are not ready on this map to establish a camp. So, it's going to be yet another day exploring as we tour towards winter. Maybe I should explore along this road, move a little faster. Once again, if you're joining me on Twitch, today I am not in chat. My apologies. I always think I'm going to have more time in the morning than I do, and before I know it, it's 10:30 and time to stream. And I do not have a multiple monitor set up, so I have to set up a laptop in order to participate in Twitch chat. Oh, I'm no longer mighty. That's okay. We've got 3 cooked berries, 2 cooked carrots, and a cooked drumstick. Alright. We have not started getting desperate enough to jump through wormholes yet. I still do have a trap at 13%. Maybe I should have grabbed some carrot bait. But I'm really getting to the point where I want to establish a camp because I'm running out of room in my inventory. Alright, so we are now approaching these grasslands, which we've done a little bit of exploration. But if my stated goal is to find a beefalo herd so I can establish a semi-permanent camp, I think this is the best place to look. Oh, there we go. Beefalo. Okay, so now we just need to find a location somewhat near this little beefalo herd that is suitable for camping. And maybe put down a permanent fire. Let's see here. Maybe I can get lucky and find some gold. The controls are not wanting to mine here. Alright. Come on, gold. Nope, more nitra, flint. We're gonna need bunches of rocks anyway. A little bit more grass. Alright, so maybe over here is a good location for our camp. It's a little bit of a hike to the beefalo herd, but looks defensible. Got a few carrots. I can probably pull some bushes for berries down here. We got some ponds up here. I think I have a fishing rod where I can fish out of those ponds. Yes, I do. It's not a bad source of food. And it is raining. That's going to bring things down pretty quickly. Got some bees. Yeah, I think I'm gonna just grab some berries right now. But I do think that the location for our camp has been found. I'm just going to have to do some little bit more ranging out to hopefully find some gold. So we can get our science machine rolling. Roasted berries go bad so fast. Alright, yep. So we're in the dark. It's raining. We do not have an umbrella. I want to establish on a defensive place with enough room to make a few machines and structures. Yeah, this probably looks like the best place to drop a permanent fire. Alright, so we've still got 15 rocks. I'm going to be able to pick this up. I think that I'm starting to run low enough on wood that chopping this tree down is a good idea anyway. And it's raining pretty good. I don't know if I know how to make a shovel yet or if that's something that is beyond me science-wise. It totally is. Yeah, this is disappointing because I still am short that gold. Whoa, okay. Well, that was unexpected. Could have been a early end to my survival series here. My nice feather hat. Yeah, this is going to be... Oh, yeah, this is going to take fuel like nothing else when it rains.
He's good fire, no?
Oh, Wolfgang. I guess we can roast these berries. It has been a while since I have played before starting the series, but I think I played after they did the second winter update, and I have had to fight some of the monsters of the winter, the tusk, the mech tusks. Also, I can't remember the big cyclops thing that smashes all of your stuff. But I have had to deal with him as well. I think it's time to take out that fried drumstick. Wow. Gives a lot of food. Alright, that lightning at least cleared out that stump for us since we don't have the knowledge of shovels. Do I have any weapons? No, I don't know how to make a spear. Plan tomorrow, maybe running up this way out here would be a good idea to try and find that gold. Might be time to trap a rabbit for tasty murder. I'm definitely going to have to get a few more logs. At least it's done raining. And the fire should easily survive till morning. Alright, our sanity is relatively intact. Quick pick a couple of flowers to bolster that a bit. Quick daily save. Let's at least find the boundaries of our land here. Wow, there's a lot of bees. Man, I've definitely been here because all the berry bushes have been picked clean. Can't remember if I get anything from chopping these. No, I don't. Let's just eat all of the berries. Actually, I'm just going to eat everything. Alright. Okay. Don't have a lot of options for possible locations to find gold at the moment. I don't want to have to wander too far from camp, but let's at least clear the map. Okay, we've got some frog dudes. Oh yeah, they're hostile. Try and lick me to death. Luckily they're not very fast. So I guess that I miss my opportunity to fish without having to fight those things. Now, my campsite is kind of poorly marked on the map, okay? And if I remember right, I've always had the most success finding gold in a big rocky area, which we have not found any of so far. Area where there will be tall birds, tall bird nests, and a lot of rocks that actually look like they have gold veins in them. I remember in early incarnations of the game, all rocks were pretty much created equal, but it looks like that's no longer the case. Wow, if this wasn't so far from the beefalo herd, this peninsula would have been a great spot to camp. I always like to set up defenses for hounds, where I don't have to worry about building walls from more than one angle. Just can set up little palisades and trap the heck out of them. Now, it looks like I chose poorly in terms of the direction to walk. So I'll get as far as I can. I may actually need to make a temporary fire if I range out too far and can't get back to camp. We're finding the borders of the islands. Not as useful as finding gold. Because the game really is going to kick into high gear as soon as I can start researching some basic stuff. But without science, I'm just out here picking berries. Man. Alright, I have a bad feeling about this. That I actually probably had to go much further. Because if I want to make it back to my camp and still have time to chop firewood, let's see, I have 8 logs left. Yeah, firewood may be not a thing today. Yeah, looks like I have pretty much mapped this area out. Try and get back to the road. Looks like the end of day 6 is going to be making it back to the permanent camp. And realizing that this is not the way you want to walk. I will be back for your meat at some point. Besides just meat and access to poop, what's that? Animal tracks. We are not going hunting for the animal. For the pachyderm thingy. The other reason I needed to find beefalo is because we're not too far off of needing access to their fur. Because my breezy jacket's at 25%. I'm going to want a winter coat as soon as winter comes. But if I can't figure out the technology to start making better food, more efficient food... my biggest problem isn't necessarily just going to be the temperature. Gotta be pretty close to camp. There it is. I got a little time to chop some trees. Lack of technology is going to make it very difficult to survive the first winter. Which means I think tomorrow the plan for ranging is going to be... Wow, looks like most of that's been discovered. Am I going to have to go all the way through these woods? I mean, I basically have to pick a direction. Either go this way through the plains, or this way through the woods. Get a few more logs for the fire. I've got 14 now. I'd like to be able to entirely focus tomorrow on Exploration. I think I can roast the seeds, too. Alright, we're close enough tonight to get the fire going. And I'm not going to have to feed it quite as often since there's no rain tonight. Guess we'll just cook all of this. Cook some seeds. That barely gives you any hunger. But at least they are easy to find. My mighty arms can carry no more. Alright, so we are on the night of day 6. We will, after surviving the night, presumably, be working on the last, let's see. I think there's a few things I can drop here, because I don't need the fishing rod away from camp. I know where the ponds are, and they're nearby. The next time it rains, I think I'll be able to go there. I still don't know what this stuff does. Can I? No, I can't burn it. It's got to be used in a recipe. I know I played since they added it, but I can't recall at all what it does. I've got plenty of flint, plenty of twigs and grass. Alright, supplies are doing okay, aside from not having a science machine. However, come morning, this will mark the end of episode 3, and hopefully, with the next episode, we're going to see what I can find and actually get some science done. I'd like to thank you for watching the Survivor series, playing Don't Starve with Wolfgang. Until next time, I am Doc Stout, and I am signing out.